In Beyond, we have multiple tools to help you monitor your Beyond software and your PC to check the resources and health of the system. These tools can be found while under Grid. Under Tools, we have the FP4 Data Transmission Monitor, the Core Monitor, the Network Monitor, and the Resource Monitor. We also have a couple other tools that are related, being the Network Statistics and the Performance Tuning. The FP4 Data Transmission Monitor is where you can monitor the communication between Beyond and the FP4s you have on your network. Under FP4 Diagrams, we have the main overview, which shows one graph per FP4. This graph compares the expected timing between when Beyond sends a frame of data to the FP4 and when the FP4 receives it. If you're having issues with your output, like stuttering, delay, lag, or dropouts, you can reference here to see what type of data issues you're having. Sometimes you will see red or yellow bars for delays or dropouts for lost packets. This can help identify network issues you may be having. You can also click Details if you need more info, change the time frame here, or display more graphs at once. Next, we have the Core Monitor. Similarly to before, this is a live graph of performance, but instead of network, it is the Beyond software itself. Under Calculation Duration, this shows the overall milliseconds it takes for Beyond to complete one cycle. The calculation per second shows how busy overall Beyond is, and the load shows how much CPU load the PC is experiencing. If your software is lagging or having trouble having high frame rates, this is a great place to check to see if it's your PC performance causing the issue. Under Drawing Duration, this shows timing related to frame calculation specifically. And under Script Duration, you can see the timings related to mostly Pango scripts, so if you're having issues with your Pango scripts, you can check here to see where those issues are. Below that, we have the Network Monitor. Network Monitor lets you see all active connections on your PC, their IPs, and some other data related to those connections, like if that port is communicating to the FP4s or to other Beyond QS systems. Our last monitor, the Resource Monitor, shows your overall system memory usage in relation to Beyond, as well as the overall graphic processing usage related to Beyond. Now we have two other tools related to performance and monitoring, first being the Network Statistics window. This mainly provides detailed information about protocols, and for each individual connection the PC has. This data isn't super useful on a day-to-day, but could be useful in very complex network setups for your shows. Lastly, we have the performance tuning window. Now let's say you do have an issue like lag or frame delays or something like that, and you have discovered it using the tools we have just talked about. What do you actually do? Well, this is where performance tuning comes into play. While it doesn't fix a bad network connection or speeds up your PC, it can change how Beyond works with your network and your PC to optimize how it will calculate, and this often helps stabilize your system over the short term. It is important to note, this is not telling your PC how to interact with Beyond, but telling Beyond how to work with your PC. So if you're having lag or flickering output, you don't actually want to go higher, you want to go lower on the amount of usage. The best way to use performance tuning is to play whatever queue or timeline or script that is giving you the issue, and try each optimization profile to find which gives you the best performance. Sometimes the economized profile will give you substantially better performance on a lower end PC, so give all of them a try to find the best for your PC and your specific setup. Thanks for watching this video on the Beyond monitoring tools and performance tuning. If you're still having trouble, you can contact support by emailing support@penguin.com and we'll help you as soon as possible.